हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल विवान एजुकेशन। वी आर डिस्कसिंग क्लास 10th चैप्टर 6 प्रोग्रेशंस। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी कंप्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 6.4। एक्सरसाइज 6.4 इज अबाउट व्हाट जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशंस। इफ यू मिस्ड दिस क्लास आई गिवन लिंक इन डिस्क्रिप्शन, वंस यू चेक इट। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट nth टर्म ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक प्रोग्रेशन। सो इन प्रीवियस क्लास टिल वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट ओनली general form. Now we'll discuss about the nth term. So we know that a, ar, ar square, ar cube, ar power 4 and so on is a general form of geometric progressions, right? Here we know a1 or a is a first term and a2 is a second term. How will you get a second term? Means by multiplying first term with a common ratio, nothing but a into r is the second term. Then a3, how will you get the third term of GP? Means we had to multiply second term with a common ratio, nothing but ar into r becomes ar square, isn't it? Then a4, how will you get fourth term? Means we had to multiply third term with a common ratio, nothing but ar square into a, it becomes ar cube, right? So on, we know this one, because already we discussed this form in exercise 6.4. Now we'll derive nth term from this general form. Now what we'll say about nth term? Yes, so observe here considering power 1, r power 1. So see, a2 means we are getting power 1, 3 means 2, 4 means 3. That means what? We are decreasing the value by 1. Okay, so observe here, A2 nothing but A into R power 1, right? So this one I am writing as A into R power 2 minus 1. Second term is decreasing by 1. Third term, right? A into R power 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. Fourth term means A into R power 4 minus 1. Then you will get 3. Isn't it? That means each term we are decreasing by 1. Now what do you say about An? So for n also, for nth term also, we have to decrease by how much? 1 only. Nothing but a into r power n minus 1. That means what? An is equals to a into r power n minus 1. So when given a first term a and common ratio r, then we can say nth term of the GP, an is equals to a into r power n minus 1. Yes, what is the nth term of GP? An is equals to A into R power N minus 1. Okay. So, based on this condition, we'll observe some examples now. See, find the 20th and nth term of GP 5 by 2, 5 by 4, 5 by 8, so on. What we have to find here? We have to find the 20th term and the nth term. Isn't it? So, first solution. Given what here? GP is 5 by 2, 5 by 4, 5 by 8 and so on. Here we know first term here A is equals to A or A1 is equals to 5 by 2. So now we know here A, we have to find what? R. R is the common ratio. How will find the common ratio? We have to divide by second term with the first term, A2 by A1 or A3 by A2. So I am doing here A2 by A1. A2 is 5 by 4 by A1 is 5 by 2. So this is equals to 5 by 4. This becomes what? Reciprocal. 5 by 2 becomes 2 by 5. And 5 cancelled. Then remaining what here? 2 1s and 2 2s. So common ratio R is equals to, we got how much here? 1 by 2. Now here we know A value, that means what? First term and the common ratio. Now what we had to find? We had to find the 20th term and the nth term. Isn't it? So then first A20 means what? A into R power 19. Yes. So because in the formula An is equals to A into R power N minus 1. Now we are finding the 20th term. That means in place of N we had to replace 20 ma. Then A into R power N value 20 minus 1. Then A20 is equals what? A into R power 20 minus 1 is what? 19. How will you get this one? Means by using nth term formula. Now this is equals to A value how much? 5 by 2 into r is the ratio, how much we got? 1 by 2 whole power 19. Yes, this is equals to 5 by 2 into 1 power 19 means 1 only by 2 power 19. Okay, this implies the 5 ones are 5 by, you know the formula, a power m into a power n is equals to a power m plus n. A power m into a to the power of n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. So power should be 1 here. 1 plus 19 is 20. So 2 power 20. So answer is what? 5 by 2 power 20. Yes, are you getting? So this is what? A 20 value. Now we had to find what? Nth term also we had to find. That means an we had to find. Second one, an. Nth term formula what? A into r power n minus 1. This is equals to a given 5 by 2 first term. And we got the common ratio r is a 1 by 2 whole to the power of n minus 1. Yes. So this is equals to 5 by 2 into 1 power something is always 1 only and 2 power n minus 1. Is it okay? This implies 5 ones are 5 by, again same formula, a power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. So here 2 power 1 into 2 power n minus 1. So adding minus 1 plus 1 cancelled. Right. So what is answer? 2 power n. An is equals to 5 by 2 power n. Okay, so we find out what here 20th term and nth term of the GP. Now observe here, second example, which term of the GP? 2, 2 root 2, 4, so on is 128. So what is given here? Given first term, second term, third term given. Now 128 is which term of the GP? Maybe 10th term or 11th term, like that we have to find. Okay, so first we'll write the given geometric progression here. What is the given here? 2 comma, 2 root 2 comma, 4 comma, so on. Yes, here clearly we know A1 or A is equals to how much? 2. Nothing but first term is 2. We have to find common ratio. How will you find a common ratio? Second term to the first term. Nothing but A2 by A1 or A3 by A2. So, I am doing here a2 by a1, second term by first term. What is second term? 2 root 2 by a1 is 2. Now, 2 2 cancel, then what is the answer? Root 2. That means common ratio how much? Root 2. Yes, are you getting everyone? So, we know the first term and common ratio. Now, we have to find what? Which term of the GP is 128? Now, here 128 I am considering as the nth term. Let 128 be the nth term of the GP. Nth term of the geometric progression. That means what? An is equals to 128. Okay. So, we know the formula. Nth term of the GP. An is equals to what? A into r power n minus 1 is equals to an given as 128. Is it okay everyone? This implies a value. How much? 2. Into r is a common ratio, how much we got? Root 2 and the whole power what? N minus 1 equals to 128. Yes, are you getting everyone? Now see, this implies root 2 whole power n minus 1 is equals to 128. This multiplication becomes division by 2. Okay, now doing cancellation here, 2 6 are 12 and 2 4 are 8. So this implies we got here what? Root 2 whole to the power of n minus 1 equals to 64. Now here we have to find n, right? So here root 2 is there. I am cancelling the root. If you cancel the root, it becomes what? 1 by 2. 1 by 2 nothing but n minus 1 by 2. Here I am doing cancellation of root. It becomes by 2 equals to 64. Now here I am equating 64 to 2 powers. So finding prime factors for 64. 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4 and 2 16s are 32, 2 8s are 16 and 2 4s are 8 and 2 2s are 4. So 1 2 3 4 5 6, what are 2 power 6 and here 2 power n minus 1 by 2 writing same. Now see here bases are same, right? We know that if a power m is equals to a to the power of n, if bases are equals, we had to equate the powers, nothing but m equals to n. Yes, now observe here, bases are same, right? Now we had to equate the powers. Then equate, what will happen? N minus 1 by 2 equals to 6, based on a power m is equals to a power n formula. Now this implies n minus 1 is equals to, doing cross multiplication, 2, 6 are 12. This implies n is equals to 12, transpose, the minus quantity becomes what? Plus 1. This implies n is equals to 12 plus 1 is 13. That means what? 128. 128 is the 13th term of the geometric progression. If you find A13, you will get 128 compulsory. Okay? See, we'll see here. A13 means what? A into R power 12. Right? So, A value how much? 2. Whole power. R value how much? What is the ratio we got? Root 2 whole power 12. So, this is equal to 2 into, if you cancel the root, it becomes what? 1 by 2, nothing but 12 by 2. 2 1s and 2 6s. So, 2 times of 2 power 6 means what? 64. Okay? 2 4s are 8, 2 6s are 12. See, 128 we got, right? Yes. So, 13th term of the GP is 128. Okay? Next, example 3 ma. So, last example. So, what is the example given here? In a GP, the third term is 24 and the sixth term is 192. Find the 10th term. Given what here? Third term given. Third term is what? 24 and the sixth term is 192. We have to find the 10th term. Okay. Solution. Given A3 is equals to 24 and A6 is equals to 192. A3 means what, Nana? A into R power 2. AR square is equals to 24. Considering as the equation number 1, A6 means what, ma? A into R power 5 is equals to 192. Considering equation number 2. Yes, are you getting everyone? Yeah. Now, to find the 10th term, we have to know first term A and common ratio R. That means we have to find A and R first. So, to find A and R, I am dividing equation 2 and with equation number 1. Dividing equation 2 by equation 1. So, what is equation 2 here? A into R power 5 by A into R square is equals to 192 by 24. Yes, equation 2 by equation 1. Now, observe here. A into R power 5, here denominator having R square. To cancel, R power 5 I am writing as what? R cube into R square by A into R square. Right? Because A power M into A power N is equals to A power M plus N. Again 3 plus 2 becomes 5 only. Equals to 192 by 24. Now see here, A cancelled. R square cancelled. Then what is the remaining here? R cube is equals to, now doing here cancellation, 24 1s and 24 8s are 192. So, R cube is equals to how much we got here? 8. So, R cube is equals to 8, doing prime factors for 8. 2 4s are 8 and 2 2s are 4. So, nothing but 8 is equals to 2 cube. Right? So, 2 power 3. Now, see here, powers are same. Now, equating the bases. Then, R is equals to how much? 2. So, that means what? The common ratio is how much? 2. So, we got the common ratio. Now, we had to find what? First term. To find 10th, then now we had to know compulsory A, right? So, R is equals to 2. I am substituting in equation number 1 to get the value of A. R is equals to 2, replacing in equation number 1 to get the value of A. So, what is equation number 1? A into R square. R is what? 2 square equals to 24. Isn't it? This implies A into 2 square means what? 4 equals to 24. To get A, 24, this multiplication becomes what? Division by 4, 4 1s and 4 6s. This implies first term A is equals to 6. Now observe here, we got first term A as 6 and common ratio R. That means we got A and R. Now we have to find what? 10th term, right? That means what? A10. A10 means what? A into R to the power of 9. right? So a value, how much we got? 6 into r is the common ratio, we got it 2 power 9. Yes, this implies 6 into 2 power 9 means 512. So 6 2 is 12, 1 is a carry, 6 1 is 6, 6 plus 1 is 7, and 6 5 is 30. Nothing but therefore 8 10th term of the GP is 3072. Okay, so this is about what? Example 3. So in this case we had to find about A and R. So we had to divide equation 2 and equation 1. So we'll get, we are getting here R value. R value replaced in equation number 1 or 2 to get the value of A. So after getting A and R, we can find any term of the GP. Okay. So exercise 6.5. Now this total exercise 6.5 is about the relation of first term and common ratio R and AN. Okay. So 6.5, from this exercise 6.5 compulsory you will get a question. Okay, maybe chance to get a 4 marks question also. So first bit, see here, for each geometric progression find the common ratio R and find AN. So here given GP, sir, we had to find what a common ratio R we had to find and AN, nothing but nth term we had to find. Okay, so first one is given as what? 3, 3/2, 3/4, 3/8, so on. So given GP is 3, 3/2, 3/4, 3/8, so on. We know that here first term A1 or A is equals to 3. Now we know here A. Now we have to find what? R. R is the common ratio. How will you find the common ratio? By dividing A2 and A1. Second term by first term. Or third term by second term. Or fourth term by third term. So we'll get the same common ratio. So A2 value 3/2 by A1 value 3. This implies 3/2 into 3. Nothing but here considering by 1. It becomes what? Reciprocal. Nothing but 1/3. 3 cancelled. Then what is the common ratio? 1/2. Yes, are you getting? If you do 3/4 by 3/2 also will get same common ratio as 1/2 only. So we got, therefore R is equals to common ratio we got as 1/2. Then we have to find what? AN. AN is equals to what? A into R power N minus 1. Then AN is equals to A is what here? 3 into R is the common ratio. How much is there? 1/2 whole to the power of N minus 1. Yes, so we got here AN and R. Therefore, we can conclude that R is equals to 1/2 and AN is equals to 3 into 1/2 whole power N minus 1. That's it. Now, observe second one. 2, -6, -18, -54 and so on. Solution. First, we'll get the given GP is what? 2, -6, 18 and -54. Right? So here, first term A1 or A is equals to 2. Now we have to find a common ratio. So R is equals to what? A2 by A1. What is the, so here A1 is 2, A2 minus 6, A3, 18, A4 is minus 54. Doing A2 by A1, that means minus 6 by 2. 2 1s and 2 3s. So what is the answer? Minus 3. So R is the common ratio, we got a minus 3. Suppose if you want to do A3 by A2. So A3 what is there here? 18 by A2 means minus 6. Observe here. 6 1s and 6 3s. Again you'll get minus 3. Yes. So common ratio already we got minus 3 now. We have to find AN. Nth term of GP. AN is equals to, we know the formula, A into R power N minus 1. This equals to A value how much? 2 into R value how much we got? Minus 3 whole power N minus 1. Okay. So we got AN is equals to 2 into minus 3 whole power N minus 1. Therefore, we can conclude that common ratio R is equals to minus 3 and AN is equals to 2 into minus 3 whole power N minus 1. Yes, are you getting everyone? This is the second one. Next, third one. So all are same method. We had to find the common ratio and nth term for these all questions. So First, we let the GP. Given GP what? Minus 1, minus 3, minus 9, minus 27 and so on. Okay. Here we know A1 or A is equals to minus 1 is the first term. We have to find the common ratio. Or we have to find. So, we know that. Or how will you get A2 by A1? By doing what? A2 by A1. Second term with the first term. What is the second term here? Minus 3 by first term is minus 1. Minus minus cancelled and 1 3 is the 3. That means the common ratio we got as 3 here. Right? After getting common ratio, what we have to find? We have to find an. Nth term. Nothing but a into r power n minus 1. Is equals to a value how much? Minus 1 into r value 3 whole power n minus 1. Okay, so this is what an. Therefore, an is equals to minus 1 into 3 power n minus 1 and r equals to 3. Yes, fourth one. Given GP is what? 5 comma, 2 comma, 4 by 5 comma, 8 by 25 and so on. Here we know A1 or A is the first term given as 5. Now we have to find a common ratio R. So we have to find A2 by A1, second term by first term. What is second term here? 2. And what is the first term here? 5. So R is equals to 2 by 5. Now we have to find what An. An is equals to what is the formula? A into R power n minus 1. First to A value 5 into R value 2 by 5 whole to power of n minus 1. That's it. Therefore, we got R is equals to 2 by 5. And nth term, An is equals to 5 into 2 by 5 whole to the power of n minus 1. Yes? Next, second question. Observe second question. Find the 10th and nth terms of GP 5 comma, 25 comma, 125, so on. So we have to find the 10th term and nth term. Given GP what here? 5, 25, 125, so on. So first we'll write here given GP what? 5, 25, 125 and so on. Right? And here we know A1 is equals to or A equals to 5 and A2 is equals to 25, A3 is equals to 125. Right? So, already we know here first term. Now, to find the 10th term and nth term, we had to know common ratio compulsory. So, R is equal to what? A2 by A1. Second term by first term. What is second term? 25 by first term is 5. 5 1s are and 5 5s are 25. This implies a common ratio. R is equal to, we got 5. Now, here we know first term and common ratio. We had to find the 10th term. That means what? A10 we had to find. A10 is equal to what is the formula? A into R power 9. Right? So, A value given as 5 into R value how much we got? 5 power 9. Right? Nothing but 5, nothing but 5 power 1, right? So, we know the formula again. A power M into A power N is equal to A to the power of M plus N. This equals to 5 power 1 plus 9 is equal to 5 power 10. That means, A 10th term of GP is what? 5 to the power of 10. Now we have to find what? An. Nth term we have to find, right? An is equals to A into R to the power of N minus 1. So A value how much? 5 into R value how much we got? 5 only whole to the power of N minus 1. Nothing but here also 5 power 1 is same formula. A power M into A power N equals to A to the power of M plus N. Equals to 5 power 1 plus n minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 cancelled. Then 5 power n. That means what? An is equals to 5 to the power of n. Therefore, we can conclude that 10th term of the GP is 5 power 10. And nth term, an is equals to 5 power n. Yes. So, this is what when given GP, we are finding the 10th term and nth term of the geometric progression. Third one, find the indicated term of each geometric progression. So, we have to find the indicated term. So, given here, A1 equals to 9, R equals to 1 by 3, we we had to find A7. Here indicated term is A7. We had to find this value. Okay. So first we let given here solution A1 equals to A. Nothing but given. First term is 9 and R equals to 1 by 3. Common ratio given as 1 by 3. We had to find A7 equals to how much? Indicated term A7 is equals to how much? So A7 is equals to what is the formula? A into R power 6. By using nth term, A7 equals to A into R power 6. A value given as what? 9 into R value given as what here? 1 by 3 whole power 6. Right? So 9 we can write as what? 3 square, right? 3 square into this one I am writing as 1 power 6 means 1 only by 3 power 6. Is it clear? Because we know that a by b whole power m equals to a to the power of m by b to the power of m. Now 3 square 1s are 3 square by 3 power 6 we can write as what? 3 square into 3 power 4. Yes, because 2 plus 4 becomes again 6. Because we know the formula a power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. Now here 3 square and 3 square cancelled. Then what is the remaining here? 1 by 3 power 4. So this implies A7th is equals to 1 by 3 to the power of 4. So the indicated term A7 is equals to 1 by 3 power 4. Third bit, second question. Given here A1 equals to minus 12 and R equals to 1 by 3. Find A6. So here indicated term is what? A6. So first we have given here A1 is equals to minus 12 and common ratio R is equals to given as 1 by 3. Here indicated term A6 is equals to how much? Okay, we know here first term and common ratio simply we have to replace. So A6 is equals to what? A into R power 5. So A value how much? Minus 12 into R value what? 1 by 3 whole power 5. Yes, are you getting everyone? So 12 I'm writing as multiples of 3 and 4. 3 4s are 12, right? Minus is there means I'm keeping minus into 1 by 3 power 5. I'm writing as 3 into 3 power 4. 3 into 3 power 4. Nothing but power should be compulsory here. 1. 4 plus 1 becomes 5 by the formula a power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. So 3 3 get cancelled. Then minus 4 1s are 4 by 3 to the power of 4. Yes, are you getting? Therefore, indicated term A6 is equals to minus 4 by 3 to the power of 4. Yes? So this is about the third bit, second question. Next, fourth bit. So fourth bit is very, very important. So may chance to get a 2 marks question. Which term of the GP 2, 8, 32, so on is 512? So already we done this type of sum here in example, right? So which term of the GP 2 root 2, 4, so on is 128? We observed here, right? We done here. Once you check here. So this type of problem chance to get compulsory in examination. So same method we had to do here. Now here given 2, 8, 32, so on is 512. That means 512 is which term of the GP we had to find. Okay. So first we'll write that given GP 2 comma 8 comma 32 and so on. Right. So clearly here we know A1 or A is equals to 2 and the second term A2 is equals to 8, A3 is equals to 32. Right. Here we know the first term. That means we have to find the common ratio first. R is equals to what? A2 by A1. Second term by first term. So what is the second term here? 8 by what is the first term? 2. And 2 1s are and 2 4s are. That means a common ratio R is equals to, we got how much here? 4. Right? Now we have to find what? Which term of the GP is 512? That means I'm assuming 512 is the nth term of the GP. Okay? Let the nth term of the GP is 1 is what? 512. Is it okay? That means what? We know the formula what? An is equals to A into R to the power of n minus 1 is equals to what? 512. Yes, is it okay, everyone? This implies A value how much? 2 into R value how much? 4 power n minus 1 equals to 512. First, we'll find the prime factors for 512. Okay? So, 512, doing a prime factorization here. 2 2s are 4, 11. 2 5s are 10 and 2 6s are 12. 2 1s are 2 2s are 4 and 2 8s are 16. 2 6s are 12, 2 4s are 8. 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4. And 2 16s are 32. 2 8s are 16. 2 4s are 8. And 2 2s are 4. That means 512, you can write as what? 2 power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 2 to the power of 9 means what? 512. Right? So this implies that 2 into 4 is what? 2 square n power minus 1 is equals to 2 power 9. 512 we are writing as 2 powers. Nothing but 2 power 9. So here 4 writing as 2 square. Okay. This implies 2 into 2 power 2 into n is 2n minus 2 1s are 2. Right. A power m whole power n is equals to a power mn. 2 into n is 2n minus 2 1s are 2 equals to 2 power 9. Yes, are you getting everyone? Now observe here. This is in the form of what? A power m into a power n. Nothing but a power m plus n. So considering a power as 1. This implies what? 2 power 1 plus 2n minus 2 equals to 2 power 9. Right? A power m into a power n. So a power m plus n. This implies what you will get here? 2 power 2n minus 2 plus 1 is what? Minus 1 equals to 2 power 9. Now this implies we know again a power m equals to a power n. If the bases are equal, so we have to equate the powers. Then 2n minus 1 equals to 9. This implies 2n is equals to 9. Transpose minus 1 becomes what? Plus 1. Then 2n equals to what? 9 plus 1 is 10 and 2 1s are and 2 5s are 10. This implies what? N equals to 5. Okay. I am writing the formula a power m into a power n equals to a to the power of m plus n. If a power m equals to a power n, bases equal means we have to equate the powers m equals to n. Yes, are you getting? So n equals how much we got? 5. That means what? Fifth term of the GP is 512. Okay. If you find A5 means what? A into R power 4, you will get again 512 here compulsory. Okay. Next, fourth bit, second question. Root 3 comma 3 comma 3 root 3 so on is 729. That means 729 is which term of the GP we had to find. Right. Okay, first we'll write here, given GP is root 3 comma 3 comma 3 root 3 comma so on. Right? So we have to find 729 is which term of the GP. Right? Solution. So here we know A1 or A equals to first term is root 3 and A2 is equals to 3 and A3 is equals to 3 root 3. Here we know here first term, right? Now we have to find what? Common ratio. Or we have to find. How will you find? Or A2 by A1. Second term by first term. So what is the value of A2 here? 3 by A1 value root 3. Isn't it? So this implies 3 is what? Writing as root 3 into root 3 by root 3. Because A nothing but root A into root A is again we'll get A. Now root 3 root 3 cancelled. Then root 3. That means R is equals to, we got here, root 3. It means common ratio is what? Root 3. Now we have to find 729 is which term of the GP, right? Now assuming here, let 729 is the nth term of the GP. Nth term of geometric progression. That means what? AN value, how much now here? 729. Then an is equals to what? A into r power n minus 1 is equals to 729. Okay. This implies a value how much? Given root 3 into r value, common ratio, how much we got? Root 3 whole power n minus 1 equals to 729. This implies again, a to the power of m into a to the power of n, formula a to the power of m plus n, nothing but root 3 power 1 plus n minus 1 equals to 729. Now, minus 1 plus 1 cancel, then root 3 is equals to 729, right? Whole power n. Yes, are you getting everyone? Now see, find the prime factors of 729 first. So 729, bring a prime factors here. Okay. So 3 table, 3 2 is a 6, 3 4 is a 12, 3 3 is a 9, 3 8 is a 24, 3 1 is a 3, and 3 2 is a 6, 3 7 is a 21, 3 9 is a 27, and 3 3 is a 9. Okay. 729 as powers of 3, how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 3 to the power of 6. Okay. So, this implies 3. If you cancel the root, it becomes what? 1 by 2, right? Nothing but n by 2. If you cancel this root, it becomes what? Into 1 by 2. N into 1 by 2, nothing but what? N by 2. Equals to 3 to the power of 6. Yes, is it clear everyone? This implies if bases are equal, we had to equate the exponents, right? If a power m equals to a to the power of n, bases equal means we have to equate the exponents also. Nothing but n by 2 equals to 6. This implies n equals to 2, 6, 12. That means 12th term of the geometric progression is 729. If you find a 12 value, nothing but a into r power 11, you will get a 729 compulsory. Clear? So, this is about what? Question number 2. Next, question number 3. Last question in 4th beta. Given here fractions. 1 by 3, 1 by 9, 1 by 27, so on. Is 1 by 2187. So, here we had to find 1 by 2187 is which term of the geometric progression. So first we'll write here, given what, given GP 1 by 3, 1 by 9, 1 by 27 and so on, right? Here we know A1 is the first term, A1 or A equals to 1 by 3 and A2 equals to 1 by 9, A3 is equals to 1 by 27, right? Here we know the first term. Now we have to find the common ratio. So how will you find the common ratio? By dividing a second to first, nothing but A2 by A1. A2 nothing but 1 by 9 by A1 is the first term is what? 1 by 3. This implies 1 by 9 into 1 by 3 becomes what? Reciprocal, nothing but 3 by 1. So 3 1s are and 3 3s are. So 1 by 3 is the common ratio here. So we got R equals to 1 by 3. And A also how much? 1 by 3 only. Now we have to find 1 by 2187 is which term of the GP. So let 1 by 2187 be the nth term of a geometric progression. That means what we know the formula an is equals to a into r power n minus 1 is equals to 1 by 2187. Is it clear everyone? This implies A value, how much given? 1 by 3 into R. Common ratio, how much we got? 1 by 3 whole to the power of n minus 1 equals to 1 by, so 2187. Finding again prime factors. Doing a prime factorization, 2187. So, I am finding in powers of 3 because here given 3, right? So, finding powers of 3 here. 3 7s are 21. 3 2s are 6, 27, 3 9s are 27. And 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9. 3 8s are 24, 3 1s are. And 3 27s are 81, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9. So, 2187 as a powers of 3. How much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, 3 to the power of 7. Yes, is it okay everyone? So, 1 by 3 power 7. Right? So, Now observe here again, a power m into a power n, a power m plus n. So 1 by 3 to the power of 1 plus n minus 1, power nothing, that means we should consider 1, equals to 1 by 3, considering here whole power 7. 1 by 3 power 7, writing as 1 by 3 whole power 7, because of 1 power 7 also, 1 only. 3 power 7 we got as it is. Now here, minus 1 plus 1 cancelled. Then what is the remaining here? 1 by 3 whole power n is equal to what? 1 by 3 whole power 7. See, bases are equal. We had to equate the exponents. Nothing but n equals to 7. We know that a power m equals to a power n. Bases equal. We had to equate the exponents. Nothing but m equals to n. Yes, is it clear? Nothing but nth term. That means what? 7th term of the GP. 7th term of the GP is 1 by 2187. If you find A7, nothing but A into R power 6, you will get here 1 by 2187. Is clear? So, once I am saying this 4th bit is very, very important. Okay? So, chance to get a 2 marks question compulsory. Next, question number 5. Observe question number 5. Find the 12th term of a GP whose 8th term is 192 and the common ratio is 2. Okay, we have to find what? 12th term of the GP given 8th term is 192 and the common ratio is what? 2. First, given A8 is equals to 192. 8th term of GP is given as 192 and common ratio R is given as 2. Right? This implies A8 means what now? A into R power 7 is equals to 192 considering as equation number 1. Okay? Now here given common ratio R is equals to what? 2. Right? If you replace R equals to 2 in equation number 1, we will get the value of A. If you replace R equals to 2 in equation number 1, we will get the value of A, right? So this implies R equals to 2 substituting in equation number 1. To get the value of A. This implies A into R value 2 and power 7 equals to 192. Right? So A into 2 power 7 means 2 we have to multiply 7 times. 2 power 7 is what? 128 is equals to 192. This implies A is equals to 192 by 128 because the multiplication becomes what? Division. Isn't it? So, now we'll do calculation here. 4 3s are 12 and 4 2s are 8. 4 4s are 16 means 3. 4 8s are 32. And 4 8s are 32. 4 12s are and 4 3s are 12 and 4 2s are 8. So, equals how much we got? 3 by 2. That means what? A is equals to 3 by 2. That means we got the first term A equals to 3 by 2. Now, we know here, first term A and common ratio R. We know A and R, now we have to find the 12th term of the GP. That means what? A 12 is equal to what? A into R power 11. Right? So, A value 3 by 2 into R. R is the common ratio is 2 whole power 11. Right? This is equal to what? 3 by 2 into 2 power 11. Writing as 2 into 2 power 10. Is it okay? Because a power m into a power n is equal to a to the power of m plus n. 10 plus 1 becomes again 11. Now see, 2 to cancelled. Then what is the answer? 3 into 2 to the power of 10. Okay. Therefore, a 12th term of the GP is what? 3 into 2 power 10. Observe question number 6 here. The 4th term of a geometric progression is 2 by 3. And the 7th term is 16 by 81. Find the geometric series. Okay. Once again see. Given 4th term of the GP is 2 by 3. Nothing but A4 given as what? 2 by 3. And 7th term. Nothing but A7 is given as 16 by 81. We had to find the GP. Right. Solution. So in given GP. 4th term. Nothing but A4 is given as 2 by 3. And A7 given as 16 by 81. Right? So A4 means what ma? a into r power 3 is equals to 2 by 3 considering as equation number 1, and a7 means what? A into r power 6 equals to 16 by 81 considering as equation number 2. Yes, is it okay everyone first? Now we have to find the values of a and r. If you know the first term and common ratio, then only we can find the GP. Right? So to find a and r, I'm dividing equation 2 with equation number 1. Dividing equation 2 by equation number 1. So what is equation number 2? A into r power 6 equals to 16 by 81 divided by equation 1 is what? A into r power 3 by 2 by 3. Okay? Equation 2 by equation 1. Okay. See here, A into denominator r power 3 is right. R power 6 writing as r power 3 into r power 3. Yes, is it okay? By a into r cube equals to 16 by 81. This is because what? Reciprocal. Think about 3 by 2. See, man, listen carefully. A power m into a power n is equals to a to the power of m plus n. Then 3 plus 3 becomes what? 6 only. Now, a cancelled and r cube cancelled. Then remaining what here? Only r cube. So doing here cancellation, 2 ones and 2 eights are 16. 3 ones and 3 27s are 81. So 8 by 27. So this implies r cube is equals to 8. We can write as what? 2 cube. 2 power 3 means 8. 27 is what? 3 cube. Right? So nothing but this one we can write as what? 2 by 3 whole cube. Is it okay? Because 8 by 27 is what? 2 cube by 3 cube. Isn't it? So a power m by b power m is equals to a by b whole power m. A to the power of m by b to the power of m equals to what? A by b whole power m. Yes? So writing 2 by 3 whole cube. Okay, now see here, these exponents are equal. Nothing but bases we have to equate. This implies r is equal to how much? 2 by 3. So the common ratio is equal to 2 by 3. Now we got r value, right? Now we have to find what? A. If you know a, then only we can find a series. Now r equals to 2 by 3, substituting in equation number 1 or 2. So we'll replace in equation number 1 to get the value of a. R equals to 2 by 3, substituting in equation number 1 to get the value of A. This implies, what is the equation number 1 here? A into R cube. So A into R value how much here? 2 by 3 whole cube equals to 2 by 3. Yes, are you getting everyone? This implies A is equals to 2 by 3. This multiplication becomes division, right? Nothing but it becomes a reciprocal. Nothing but 3 by 2 whole cube. Now see, multiplication becomes a division, right? Division becomes what? Reciprocal. Nothing but 2 by 3 becomes what? 3 by 2 whole cube. A is equals to 2 by 3 into, expanding this one, 3 into 3 by 2 into 2. 3 by 2, multiplying 3 times. 1, 2, 3. See, 3 cancelled and 2, 2 cancelled. Then what is the remaining? A equals to 3 is the 9 by 2, 2 is the 4. So we got the first term, A equals to how much? 9 by 4. Okay. So we know the first term and the common ratio. Now we have to find the GP. Right? What is the general form of GP? A, AR, AR square and so on. Isn't it? So this implies A is the first term. 9 by 4, comma A into R. 9 by 4 into ratio is what? 2 by 3, comma AR square. 9 by 4 into R value, 2 by 3 whole square, so on. Now observe here, 9 by 4 same cancellation, 3 ones and 3 threes are, 2 ones and 2 twos are. So what is the answer we got here? 3 by 2. And here, 9 by 4 into 2 by 3 whole square. So 9 by 4 into 2 square means 4 by 3 square means 9. 9, 9, 4, 4 cancelled. Nothing but 1 and so on. So the GP is what? 9 by 4 comma 3 by 2 comma 1 and so on is the required geometric progression. Yes, is it clear everyone? This is about what? Question number 6. Last question in exercise 6.5. Seventh question. If the geometric progressions 162, 54, 18 so on and 2 by 81, 2 by 27, 2 by 9 so on have their nth terms equal, find the value of n. Right? What is saying here? Given 2 GPs here. What is here? 162, 54, 18 is the first GP and 2 by 81, 2 by 27, 2 by 9 and so on is the second GP. And saying here, nth terms are equal. There, nth terms are equal. Nothing but nth term of first AP is equals to nth term of the second AP. Right? Then we have to find the value of n. N is equals to how much? Right? Okay, first we'll write here, given APs, given 2 APs, what are those? 162, 54, 18 and so on. And 2 by 81, 2 by 27, 2 by 9 and so on. Isn't it? So first we'll find the values of A and R for first AP. Okay? So clearly here we know A is the first term as 162 for the first AP and R is equals to what? Common ratio A2 by A1. Second term by first term. Nothing but 54 by 162. A2 by A1. So 54 1s and 54 3s. So common ratio we got how much here? 1 by 3. Now in first case, for nothing but for first GP we got A and R. So nothing but nth term. An is equals to what? A into R power n minus 1. Then an is equals to a value 162 into r value 1 by 3 whole to the power of n minus 1. This one I am considering as equation number 1. Okay. Now I am considering the second GP. What is there here? 2 by 81 and 2 by 27, 2 by 9. Here 2 by 81 is the first term. Nothing but a is equals to 2 by 81 given. Now what we have to find? We have to find the common ratio. How will we find the common ratio? A2 by A1. Right? Or A3 by A2. So we'll do here. A2 by A1. A2 is what done here? 2 by 27 by A1 is 2 by 81. Okay? This implies 2 by 27. This becomes what done? Reciprocal. Nothing but 2 by 81 becomes 81 by 2. 2 cancelled. 27 1s and 27 3s. So R equals to 3. Now for second GP also we got A and R. And we know that nth term formula what? An is equals to A into R power n minus 1. Yes. Then An is equals to A value 2 by 81 into R value 3 power n minus 1. Considering as equation number 2. Yes. And given what is the condition given? Their nth terms are equal. Given their nth terms are equal. Nothing but equating equation 1 and equation number 2. So what is it? This implies what is equation 1 here? 162 into 1 by 3 whole to the power of n minus 1 is equals to 2 by 81 into 3 into n power minus 1. So I am equating equation number 1 and equation number 2. Right? So 162, this multiplication becomes what? An, division. So division again, it becomes what? Reciprocal. That's why I am writing directly here. 2 by 81 becomes 81 by 2. Okay? Actually, this multiplication becomes division. Division becomes what? Reciprocal. So, directly I am writing here 2 by 81 as 81 by 2. Okay, once see here 162 by 1. Right? So, this becomes what now? 2 by 81. Okay? Because multiplication becomes division. Now, see here 162 into reciprocal of 2 by 81 is what? 81 by 2. So, I written here directly. Okay? Is equals to what? 3 to the power of n minus 1 into, see same, multiplication becomes division. multiplication becomes division, and division again becomes reciprocal. So it becomes what? 3 to the power of n minus 1. Do same process ma. Okay, multiplication becomes division, again it becomes reciprocal, you will get again 3 to the power of n minus 1. So observe here, 2 1s are 2, 2 8s are 16, and 2 1s are 2. This implies what? 81 into 81 is equals to, see, a to the power of m into a to the power of n, nothing but a to the power of m plus n, isn't it? So adding the exponents, n minus 1 plus n minus 1. Okay, now see here, this implies here base is 3. Now 81 we can convert as power of 3, right? So 81 is 3 to the power of 4. 3 power 4 means 81. So observe here, finding by prime factorization, 3 2s are 6, 3 7s are 21, 3 9s are 27, and 3 3s are 9. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 81 we can write as what? 3 to the power of 4. Right? 3 to the power of 4. Into again 81, 3 to the power of 4 is equals to 3 to the power of n plus n is what? 2n minus 2, because 2 negatives we can add. Here also same formula, I am adding the exponents. 3 power 4 plus 4 is what? 8 equals to 3 to the power of 2n minus 2. Yes, are you getting? So 81 writing as 3 power 4, again 3 power 4. So by using formula what? 8 to the power of m into 8 to the power of n, a to the power of m plus n. So I am adding the exponents here. Here also I am adding the exponents. Now see here, having bases are equal. If bases are equal, we had to equate the exponents. So what are the exponents we are having here? 8 equals to 2n minus 2. Okay, again saying here, bases are equal. Bases are equal, we had to equate the exponents. This implies that 2n is equals to 8. Transpose minus 2 becomes what? Plus 2. This implies 2n is equals to 8 plus 2 is what? 10. This implies n is equals to 10 by 2. Think about the multiplication becomes a division. 2 1s are and 2 5s are 10. This implies n is equals to what? 5. That means what? Fifth term of the two GPs are equal. Okay, if you find A5 for these two GPs, then these two GPs are equal. Clear? So for the value of n equals to 5, these two GPs are equal. Okay, so this is about what exercise 6.5. Right, so with this we completed exercise 6.5, means chapter also completed. In next class we'll start chapter number 1, real numbers. Okay, so I hope you got it. Thank you so much.